So I'm in my 2014 Tesla Model S here, and I've got to go and pick my daughter up from the other side of London. So I thought I'll measure the driving efficiency, because that's something I've sort of ignored with this car. And these are actually pretty heavy on the electrons. So it's all motorway driving I've got to do, A34, M4 to the M25, round the M25, right round to Seven Oaks, and then drive back. It's a Friday afternoon, so worst time to be on the M25. As you can see, it's already getting busy, lots of red when that comes back. Anyway, it's saying 2 hours 3 minutes. I'm sure that will get longer as I start driving, because I'm going to hit rush hour traffic there. You can see all the red, and this bit is bad normally. But certainly by the time I've picked her up and turning around and coming back, that's going to be very busy. So it's going to be probably two and a half hour, maybe even a 3 hour drive getting there. And it's going to be the same sort of time getting back. But anyway, let's reset the driving efficiency. That's something I've never actually done on this car. Well, 26,000 miles was the last time I reset anything. So I'm going to reset trip A. So that's all reset to naught now. And just have a look at what the efficiency of this car is. And that is driving in the rain. It's the 21st of April today, but it's surprisingly cold today. It's only 6 degrees. So I'm going to have the heater on all the time. I'm going to have my heated seat on. I'm going to turn that up to max. And it's all going to be fast driving, so we'll see what it looks like later on today. So just before I pull away here, I better just show you, the battery is at 68% state of charge. I haven't fully charged it because I'm very strict on the 4 hour charging window, so this vehicle is only charged on cheap rate nighttime electricity. So it didn't have a chance to fully charge, because I was using this for long distance driving yesterday as well. So it says we're going to get to the destination with a 23% battery, which is fine, because at this destination is a Tesla supercharger, which is why I've picked this. So I'll be able to charge it up to get back, and on Tesla superchargers my charging is free, because this is an old Tesla where you get free supercharging for the life of the vehicle, hence why I only do a 4 hour charge and often do trips like this where I leave where the vehicle isn't fully charged, because for me it's cheaper to charge while I'm out there using the supercharger network. Donnington Manor Hotel near Seven Oaks. Here they've got 8 Tesla superchargers around the back in the car park. They're 250 kilowatt version 3s. So my battery is now at 26%, so I'm going to plug in and run inside for a wee. Oh, that's so much better now. Anyway, so still got the heating on, still got the heated seat on even though it's warmed up, had that on all the journey. The driving was more efficient probably, because there was a lot of stop start and the overall speed was low just because the roads were so busy. But anyway, 304 watt hours per mile. I'm just checking my phone here because I don't understand what hours per mile. I work in miles per kilowatt hour. That's 3.3 miles per kilowatt hour. So the reason why I thought I'd make this video is these early Tesla Model S's. This is a 2014 rear-wheel drive, single motor. These are pretty inefficient. Obviously, they're a big, heavy, powerful car. So you're never going to get great economy out of one of these. The newer Teslas with dual motors and the new Model S, far, far more efficient than these early ones. This is very much a Generation 1 Model S. So, yeah, when you're on a journey, 3.3 miles per kilowatt hour is probably the best you're going to see. I typically average 3 miles per kilowatt hour in this car. But anyway, the drive back might be a little bit better because a lot more of it we're going to miss the rush hour, because M25 on a Friday, worst time to be anywhere near the M25. And yeah, it's just stop start all the time, but in between the stopping, it, you know, you can stick your foot down. So actually the driving was probably pretty inefficient because it was a lot of hard acceleration. But anyway, I'm here on the Tesla superchargers in the back of the car park in this hotel. My daughter's about 20 minutes away, so we'll probably stay a bit longer because I could do with a coffee, and I'll take her in there and have a drink first because she's had quite a long drive to this drop-off point here as well. So it is charging now, and okay, now I've changed the screens, haven't I? We used to have all the information up there, but since this major update where you got the version 11, all the information's disappeared off there. Anyway, yes, it's basically got an hour. I've got it set to 100%. Of course, I'm not going to charge to 100%. But anyway, I'll be doing about a 45-minute charge here, which would give us time to go in the hotel, have a coffee. Okay, so I will continue, drive back, and then look at the overall economy when I get back. And that's sort of a four-hour drive in the UK. I know it's only going to be 200 miles. A lot of people really focus on the mileage, but the roads in the UK are just so busy, so I think focusing on how many hours driving is actually a better metric when you're looking at driving in the UK, to be honest. I've just realised it tells me up there the duration of the current trip. So 93 miles, 2 hours, 34 minutes. So yeah, it didn't feel a long drive. That's ridiculous, isn't it? To take 2.5 hours to do 93 miles when it's all dual carriageway and motorway, virtually door to door. So anyway, it's not going to be a 4-hour drive. It might be a 5-hour drive today. But anyway, I'll see you when we're back.
17 miles on a freeway, dragging my heart through a relay. When will my skin feel sea spray? 17 miles on the freeway. Can we just one time allow the rules to break? Leave the reins behind and together walk away.
That's it, just got back. It's now 7:30, so a ridiculous amount of time just to do that trip. But let's have a look at the trips. So in total, 186 miles, and that's taken all afternoon, but it's because it's M25. There was an accident going down on the other side of the road, multi car pile up, and our side was creeping along in first gear. Obviously, it's always first gear in a Tesla, an electric car, but anyway. And then coming back the other side of the road, another multi-car pile up. It looked like there was five cars involved on the other side of the M25, but again, whatever side it's on, both sides just come to a halt. So a lot of the journey on the M25 is just very slow, but it's a Friday, typical Friday. Anyway, 293 watt hours per mile there. Use 54 kilowatt hours of electricity. So looking at my phone, 293 watt hours per mile is 3.41 miles per kilowatt hour. So actually it's not too bad. It's not ionic efficiency that we used to with the other car, but for one of these, it's not too bad. So while these Model S's aren't particularly efficient, well, these first generation rear-wheel drive models anyway, they just really come into their own when you're doing the long distance motorway driving. They're just a fantastic long distance cruising car. They're just comfortable, quiet and powerful. They're just really good at overtaking, nipping into gaps and things like that, because they just pick up regardless of what speed you're doing. And yeah, they just really come into their own when you're doing motorway driving. Driving around the town and rural roads locally, they're a little bit big for the UK, particularly where we are driving on little rural B roads. They are quite wide, but doing those sort of long distance trips, while that wasn't long distance, it was certainly long time. It was been all afternoon and evening. There's not many cars I've been in which are as nice to drive as a Model S, to be honest. And looking at the trip driving back, that since the charge at the Tesla superchargers, 281 watt hours per mile, that's 3.56 miles per kilowatt hour. So much better efficiency driving back, but it was a lot more of it was faster driving. And once I got on the M4, it was flying all the way. So anyway, not sure how useful that's going to be to anyone. I suppose if you're thinking about buying an older Model S, this is just a rear-wheel drive one, single motor. These are the least efficient of the Model S range. I suppose the only other vehicle in the Tesla range which is going to be less efficient than this will be a Model X of the same age. But actually, they've all got dual motors, so maybe they are more efficient than this. But anyway, as far as Teslas go, these older first generation 2014 vehicles in the UK, these are the least efficient of all the Teslas. But when you've got an 85 kilowatt hour battery, who cares what the efficiency is really? This does 200 to 220 mile range realistic. Yeah, really efficiency doesn't matter too much unless you're going to do lots and lots of long driving. But that's what people focus on, actually, when you're looking at EVs, is the long-distance driving, but most of us don't do that. The average in the UK is something like 25 to 30 miles a day, and if you can charge at home, then, you know, it's quite rare that you need 200 to 220 miles in a day. So that'll do. I've come back with 52% battery left still, because I charged to 89 to 90% at the supercharger this afternoon. So I've got to do this trip again on Sunday. It's now Friday night, so Sunday late morning we've got to do the same trip again. So I'll be leaving with a similar sort of state of charge, and I'll charge up at that same hotel again for my return trip. And as I said before, just because it's free really. If it wasn't free, then I would charge more at home on the wall charge, the wall box charging unit just there. But when you get free supercharging, you might as well take advantage of it when you're out and about. So that's why I don't leave with a full state of charge. Anyway, I'm waffling as always. So if you found this video useful, please do click the thumbs up button, really does help. I don't think too many will, but on this video, it's probably a rather boring video, but anyway, I'll see you on the next one. So just a little add-on, it's now Sunday and I've just done the same journey again. That's 196 miles. It's 8 degrees outside, had the heating on all the time, and it was a bit better driving, less congestion, Not completely though, still a bit of stop start on the M25. You're never going to drive on the west side of the M25 without that, unless you're driving the early hours of the morning. But anyway, consume 60 kilowatt hours of energy to do the round trip. That's 305 miles, watt hours per mile. And using the calculator there, that works out at 3.28 miles per kilowatt hour. So I hope that helps someone. If you're looking at buying an older one of these, you can then multiply that by your usable capacity in your battery, whatever battery size model you're looking at, to give you the total range and that sort of motorway driving door to door, and obviously in the sort of temperatures. Okie doke, bye then.